So good afternoon, children.
Good afternoon.
Okay. So we are doing derivatives, isn't it? We are finding the derivatives of functions. Yesterday's class, we discussed about derivatives of parametric form, isn't it? We discussed the derivatives of parametric form. Now you have the textbook, means open your textbook, children. Open your textbook, take the exercise. Parametric form, that is exercise, I think 5.6. In exercise 5.6, exercise 5.6. First one, second one, third one, fourth one are important 1 mark questions. 1, 2, 3, 4 are important 1 mark questions. Okay, nowadays, okay, if it is asked for MCQ also, this type of questions will be asked. Again, sixth one is a very important 3 mark question. Sixth one, eighth one, and tenth one put a very important mark. Tenth one. Okay. Ninth one is again an 1 mark question. Ninth one is a 1 mark question. This chapter as a whole is very important. This exercise, particularly this exercise. Okay, I think yesterday we did some questions in this part, isn't it? Is it no? Seventh one, which are the questions we did yesterday? Go through this exercise. We did some important questions, previous year's questions only we did. Instead of theta, the variable will be changed. Instead of theta, it will be t based on, okay. The 10th question and all we did using T, cos T plus T sine T, like that we did. Okay. So today we are going to start with the next one, higher order derivatives. Higher order derivatives, particularly second order derivative. What is meant by second order derivative? Yes, that one also we discussed yesterday. What is second order derivative? Second order derivative means we are differentiating the function. Yes. What are you saying? Say that one louder, Nandana.
Twice.
Second order derivative means we differentiate the given function twice. Third order derivative means we differentiate the given function 3 times. Okay. Okay. Now let's do one question in parametric form. After that, we can do the questions from higher order derivatives. Write the question. If x is equal to a cos square theta, y is equal to a sine square theta, find dy by dx. X is equal to a cos square theta, y is equal to a sine square theta, find dy by dx. How to do this? How will you solve this one? X is a function in theta, isn't it? We can find dx by d theta. X is a function in theta. Therefore, we can find dx by d theta. What is dx by d theta? Aryan, can you tell me what is dx by d theta? Aryan, give me what is dx by d theta. Rijas, give me dy by d theta. Aryan, tell me what is dx by d theta. Aryan, can you hear me? Aryan? Aryan. Okay, Michael. What is dx by d theta, Michael? Give me dx by d theta. What is the derivative of sine theta? Now we are taking the formula there, huh, Michael?
No,
what is the tell me. What is the derivative of sine theta? This one we have learned last year.
Ma'am? Aryan could not unmute because he has network issue.
Okay. Achut.
Cos theta.
Derivative of sine theta is cos theta. Okay. What is the derivative of sine square theta? How will you differentiate sine square theta? Emmanuel?
Cos square theta.
Sine square theta. Derivative of sine square theta is cos square theta is wrong.
No, two.
Sine theta. Sine theta.
Put the sine. Power in the front. Reduce the power by one.
Two sine theta.
What is derivative of x square?
2x.
2x. So what is the derivative of cos sine? Is it sine square or cos square? What's the question? Sine square theta. Cos square theta means, give me. What is the derivative of cos square theta? First,
you wrote
2 cos theta into. Then you differentiate cos. What is the derivative of cos?
Right,
minus sine. Okay, Michael. Tomorrow I'll be asking again the same formula again. Function of function rule. Listen here. Cos square theta. Michael, I am explaining this again. Listen. Okay. Derivative of x square is 2x. Okay. Derivative of x raised to n is n x raised to n minus 1. So what is the derivative of sine square theta? Okay, you can treat like x square. If it is x square, what do you have to do? We put the power in the front and reduce the power by 1. If you reduce the power by 1, already 2 is there. If you reduce it by 1, it will become 1. So we can write this as 2 sine theta into. We have to differentiate what is there in the place of x. Okay, we are treating like this x square. So what is the derivative of x here? Here in the place of x, we have sine theta. What is the derivative of sine theta? Cos theta. Okay. Same way here. Okay. Now then you differentiate this. What is dx by d theta? A into A is constant. Cos square theta, if you differentiate to cos theta into. What is the derivative of cos theta? Minus sine theta. This is what we call it as chain rule. Like a chain. How many functions are there? That much time we will write into and so on. We'll be writing the derivatives of all such functions. So it is minus 2a cos theta sine theta. Now Rijas, give me what is dy by d theta?
A 2 sine theta cos theta.
Yes, 2a sine theta cos theta. Therefore, what is dy by dx? Fania, what is dy by dx?
Dy by d theta.
Dy by d theta.
Dy by dx by d theta.
Which is equal to minus 2a sine theta, cos theta by denominator also. The same thing only we are getting here, isn't it? 2a cos theta, sine theta. So we'll get cancelled. So answer is negative 1. is negative 1. Monday, get ready for the test paper. Okay. In this chapter. Write the next one, next heading. Higher order derivatives. Higher order derivatives. Higher order derivatives. Find the second order derivatives of the following functions. Find the second order derivatives of the following function. Second order derivatives of the following functions. Second order derivative means we have to differentiate it two times. We'll be differentiating the function twice. That's why we call this as second order derivative. Okay. Now under that first one, x square plus x raised to 5 plus sine x. X square plus x raised to 5 plus sine x. Shall you do this? First you name the function. First of all, you name this as y. Because y term is not there. So we can name this as y as a function in x. Now write down what is dy by dx. Dy by dx is equal to, what is the derivative of x square? It is 2x, isn't it? Plus, what is the derivative of x raised to 5? 5x raised to 4. Plus, what is the derivative of sine x? Derivative of sine x is cos x. Derivative of sine x is cos x. So this is dy by dx. Okay. So now we want to find second order derivative. That means we have to differentiate this once again. So what is d squared y by dx square? Again, differentiate this. What is derivative of 2x? What is the derivative of 2x? Alvin? What is the derivative of 2x? Derivative of 2x is Alvin. Alvin? Okay, Michael, what is the derivative of 2x? Derivative of 2x. What is the derivative of x? What is the derivative of x? Yes, Michael, what is the derivative of x?
One by x. I didn't hear it first time.
Derivative of x.
One by x.
No. That means you have not yet started learning the formula, isn't it? That chapter is going to get over. Children, all the chapters are interconnected. I repeat this from the last week onwards. But few of them till now not taken it seriously. You think you'll be working out it out last minute. Surely it is not. It will become a blank one if you are not learning these portions regularly. Again, without learning the formula, there is no use. You will not be getting the continuity. What is the derivative of x, Dia?
1.
1. What is the derivative of x square, Nandana?
2x.
2x. Aditya, what is the derivative of tan x?
6 square.
Good. Naureen, derivative of sine inverse of x?
1 by root 1 minus x square.
Rijas, derivative of tan inverse of x?
1 by 1 plus x square.
Okay, good. Sania, derivative of x raised to x? What is the derivative of x raised to x?
Naureen,
derivative of x raised to x?
X raised to x 1 plus log x.
X raised to x into 1 plus log x. Atul, derivative of a raised to x?
A raised to x into log a.
Okay, find out what is d square y by dx square. So derivative of 2x is, 2 is constant, derivative of x is 1 plus 5 into, what is derivative of x raised to 4? 4x cube plus, what is the derivative of cos x? This minus sin x. Derivative of cos x is minus sin x. So we get 2 plus 20x cube minus sin x. 2 plus 20x cube minus sin x. Write the next one. Is it okay, children? Is it clear how we are finding the derivatives? We differentiate it twice. Once we differentiate, we get the first function. Again, we differentiate the function. So we get the second one. Write the next one. Fine. Okay, second one. 3x square plus 6x plus 1. What is the answer? What is dy by dx? What is dy by dx? What is dy by dx? Yes, Achyut, give me the answer. Achyut, what is dy by dx here?
6x plus 6.
Yes, it is 6x plus 6. And what is d square y by dx square?
6.
It is 6. So now look, what about the third order derivative? Suppose we am differentiating d cube y by dx cube. It is not asked. And just ask, it will become constant. So it is 0. Okay, so it will become 0. Next one, find the derivative. Okay, second one. E raised to x into x cube. E raised to x into x cube. Y is equal to e raised to x into x cube. What is the derivative of e raised to x? Ashwin, derivative of e raised to x. Ashwin, what about the derivative of e raised to x? Ashwin? Yes, Nandana, what is the derivative of e raised to x?
E raised to x.
Now listen, children, how to differentiate this? Here we have two functions. So this is u, this is v. We are going to use the product rule. So what is dy by dx? Dy by dx is equal to e raised to x into, what is derivative of x cube? Derivative of x cube is 3x square plus, keep x cube as such, derivative of e raised to x, which is e raised to x. Now from these two functions, we can take e raised to x as common. If you take e raised to x, we will get 3x square plus x cube. So this is our first order derivative. Got dy by dx like this. Now find out what is d square y by dx square. What is d square y by dx square? Once again, we have to use product rule. E raised to x is the first term. 3x square plus x cube is the second term. E raised to x is the first term and 3x square plus x cube is the second term. When you differentiate this, we get e raised to x into, what is the derivative of 3x square? Derivative of 3x square is 6x plus, what is the derivative of x cube? 3x square. Derivative of x cube is 3x square plus, now right, keep the second function as such, 3x square plus x cube. What is the derivative of e raised to x? That is e raised to x. Derivative of e raised to x. Yes, children. Okay, we can continue. Okay, listen. Okay, you are finding the derivative, second order derivative of e raised to x into x cube. So when you find the second order derivative, once again, we have to use the product rule. E raised to x into u into v dash. Punya, what is the derivative of 3x square plus x cube?
6x plus 3x square.
Very good. Plus, now keep second function as such, 3x square plus x cube. So what is the derivative of e raised to x? It is e raised to x, isn't it? Now once again, what we can do, we can take e raised to x as common. If you take e raised to x as common, we get 6x plus 3x square plus 3x square plus x cube. So we get e raised to x into 6x plus 6x square plus x cube. 6x plus 6x square plus x cube. Is it okay, children? Are you able to follow this method? Is it okay? Nandana, Atul?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Tanya?
Yes, ma'am.
Michael? Michael?
Yes, ma'am.
So today, okay, do these questions once again, these type of questions once again. Make it thorough with this type of questions. Write the next one. Next one. Derivative of sine of log x. Sine of log x. Sine of log x. How to do this? First, you name this as y, isn't it? What is dy by dx? What is the derivative of sine of log x, Krishna Chandran? What is the derivative of sine of log x? Krishnachandran. Krishnachandran, derivative of sine of log x.
D by dx of cos log x by x.
Cos of log x. It's not over, isn't it? By x. Cos of log x by x. So it is cos of log x by x. Now, to find the second order derivative, we have to use which rule? Look at here. Which rule we have to use here? Quotient rule, isn't it? We can use quotient rule. X into, what is derivative of cos of log x? Negative sine of log x into 1 by x. Log x, when we differentiate, 1 by x plus cos of log x, we will keep it as such, derivative of denominator 1 by x square. So these two will get cancelled. So answer is minus sine of log x plus cos of log x by x square. So in second order derivative, listen children, in your textbook, the prove that type of questions are all important questions. 11th question to 17th question are important. 11 to 17, prove that type are important. Okay, if it is MCQ, the four options will be given. Y will be given and you will be asked to check which is correct. So if you solve it only, you will get the answer. Okay. So this 11th one to 17th one are all important question. Okay. Now we can start doing from the 17th one. Yes.
Can you show the page again?
Is it okay, Achyut? Which one went wrong? We didn't complete this one?
No, ma'am. I made a mistake.
Which one? Where? Which
from third step.
Third step. That means in the derivative of cos of log x. There we are using quotient rule, isn't it? Here we are using quotient rule.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, I'm moving to the next slide. Okay, Achyut.
Yes, ma'am.
Write the question, children. Next one, 17th question. If y is equal to tan inverse of x the whole square, children, prove that questions and all. If you follow in this method only, you will get the answer. Okay, some particular methods are there. In that way, if you do, you will get the result. Prove that x square plus 1 the whole square into y2 plus 2x into x square plus 1 into y1 is equal to 2. Y is equal to tan inverse of x the whole square. Prove that x square plus 1 the whole square into y2 plus 2x into x square plus 1 into y1 is equal to 2. How to do this? What is y1, y2? Y1 and Y2 stands for first order derivative, second order derivative. Y1 is first order derivative. Y2 is second order derivative. Now listen, children. Listen, sit straight. All of you sit straight. Keep your pen down and listen how I'm proving this. Okay, whenever you're asked to prove the questions based on second order derivative, two things you have to keep it in mind. Whenever we get root, we have to square it. Don't differentiate the root functions. Is it clear? whenever we have root functions, what you have to do? We should square it. Likewise, okay, whether it is first order or second order, it's not a matter. Whenever we have root functions, prove that results. Whenever we get root functions, we should square it and we have to find. Same way, try to avoid the quotient rule. Try to avoid the quotient rule. Okay, so when you go through this question, you will understand. Listen here, look at your children. Y is tan inverse of x, the whole square. Okay, what is dy by dx here? What will be the first order derivative? Here, it is of the form derivative of x square, isn't it? What is derivative of x square? It is 2x. So 2 tan inverse of x into derivative of tan inverse of x. It is 1 by 1 plus x square. So we get y1 is equal to 2 tan inverse of x by 1 plus x square. Now listen, one second listen. Now to find the second order derivative, we have to use quotient rule. But what I said earlier, avoid the quotient rule, isn't it? Here we have denominator. How we can avoid? You cross multiply this. What you are doing here? We cross multiply. So when you cross multiply this, we will get y1 into 1 plus x square is 2 tan inverse of x. Is it okay? So now instead of using quotient rule, we can use product rule. Okay, so whenever we get root, cube root and all, you square or cube. Same way, whenever we get quotient functions, cross multiply and make use of product rule. Now differentiate. Once again, differentiate. So when you differentiate this one, we get here also again product rule. This is u, this is v. Y1 into, what is derivative of 1 plus x square? Derivative of 1 is 0 plus 2x plus 1 plus x square, we keep it as such. What is derivative of y1? Y1 means dy by dx. When you differentiate it, d square y by dx square, that is y2 equal to, here again, 2 into tan inverse of x. Tan inverse of x, if you differentiate, 1 by 1 plus x square. That is, and you simplify this, 2xy1 plus y2 into 1 plus x square is equal to 2 by 1 plus x square. Again, in the next step, you cross multiply this. You cross multiply 1 plus x square. So when we cross multiply 1 plus x square, 2x into 1 plus x square into y1 plus y2 into 1 plus x square, the whole square equal to 2. Now check whether we are getting the required results. Whether we got the required results, just the terms should be rearranged. 1 plus x square, the whole square into y2 plus 2xy1 into 1 plus x square equal to 2. So whether we have getting the required result, children? Is it okay? So the two points you note it in your textbook while proving the second order derivatives. Square roots are there means we should square it and we should remove the square root. Avoid quotient rule. By cross multiplying, we can make it as product rule. Okay, if you use this procedure, you can do the prove that questions easily. Is the previous one okay? Previous question, is it okay, Rijas? Any doubt in this question, children? Alvin? Alvin is there? Alvin?
Ma'am, can you explain the last steps once again?
See? After finding the first order derivative, you differentiate it once again. Okay, we differentiate it once again. So when you differentiate it, we are using product rule. Again, product rule. Y1 into, what is derivative of 1 plus x square? Derivative of 1 is 0 plus derivative of x square is 2x. Plus 1 plus x square, we will keep it as such. Derivative of y1. Y1 is first order derivative. When we differentiate it again, we will get y2 equal to 2 is constant, 2 into derivative of tan inverse of x is 1 by 1 plus x square. Next step, I'm just rearranging. Okay, 0 plus 2x is 2x. 2x into y1 plus y2 into 1 plus x square is 2 by 1 plus x square. Next step, you cross multiply. When we cross multiply this, we'll be multiplying with 1 plus x square throughout, isn't it? We'll be multiplying. So when you multiply this, 2x into 1 plus x square into y1 plus y2 into, already here 1 plus x square is there. When you cross multiply this, it will become 1 plus x square the whole square equal to 2. Now we are rearranging. First we write the second order derivative term, then first order derivative term equal to 2. This is what asked to prove. So we just rearrange the terms in the last line. Is it okay, Sania?
Yes, ma'am.
What about the others? Is it clear, children? So now today, note down, children, note the homework questions. Exercise 5.7, 1 to 10, you try it as homework. 5.7, 1 to 10. Try it as homework. Okay. 1 to 10, few questions we have tried. The remaining questions you tried. Differentiate it 2 times. Exercise 5.7, 1 to 10. Few questions already we did. No problem. Do it again. Practice it. Okay. Answer your attendance. Nia. Nia. That's it. Mohammad Adim. Navreen, Navreen, yes. Punya, Rijas,
yes, ma'am.
Sania, Srihari, yes, absent, isn't it? Shivani, Ashwin, 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 okay, children. Meet you in the next class. Learn the formula and come. Thank you.